Is there a genuine American contender here? Yes, there is. Now, after watching his practice runs, what are his chances? And the moment of truth is just about upon us.
The sun is just creeping up over the rim. It's maybe 5, 10 degrees. It's a little chill in the air. The snow where I'm sitting is a little bit soft. On the course, it will be extremely hard and fast. My blood begins to race when I think what's going to take place here soon. At a very young age, these skiers you'll see slid on a pair of skis for the very first time. They felt the wind in their face, and with a special spirit, they wanted to go faster. These mountains, the wind, and this obsession for speed has brought all these athletes here and soon to this starting gate. One skier will ski at 85 miles per hour, fly 150 feet through the air, racing to the valley floor. But there's one constant that they'll all have in common. Forever, their blood will race. The mountain will be their friend, and forever, they'll live with a special spirit that is that of a downhiller. To stand in this starting gate, you have to be focused on the course and especially on what you have to do. You have to set aside all other thoughts and focus just on this course.
2 minutes on the Fox de Bell Bar. 2 minutes to become a legend. Join our colleague, 1964 silver medalist Billy Kidd at the top of the mountain.
No matter how many races they've been in, there's a certain look on race day. You can see it in their faces. Confidence, concentration, the factors that will determine who wins the gold medal. Are they nervous? Well, they're all different. But I can tell you that when I was in the starting gate for the 64 Olympic downhill, I was 20 years old, I was number one. The starter said 2 minutes, and it hit me. This is the Olympics. I had one of the fastest training runs. I thought I could win the Olympic gold medal. But I had distracting thoughts in my head. A fellow racer who slid into the trees and was killed. My heart was pounding. I couldn't breathe. It felt like there was a tight belt around my chest and I couldn't get oxygen. My knees went weak.
All right, come on, hurry up. Where you guys been?
Yeah. Down the bottom of the hill, man.
What?
All right, I'll go down. You wait. Whoa, going too fast.
Downhill ski racing personifies speed. Electrifying speed on a ribbon of ice. From start to finish, these skiers hurtle their bodies down a mountainside.
Down the bottom, man.
The odds of control, they push the fine line they call the limit, and sometimes they push too far.
The course you see behind me will be a major factor today. It is unique, challenging, and without question a spectator's delight.
Says that these turns are a little too tight. If he can finish somewhere in the top seven, it'll be a great day for him. But as much of a factor as all these skiers will be in the outcome of this event, so with the course, it's truly unique.
There he is. There he is. What a stud.
Oh.
reputation. Downhill ski racing is much more than a high wire balancing act. Its technical precision and speed, where only hundredths of a second will separate the gold medal from the rest of the field.
Headball
with
a video
cam. All right, go down here.
Yeehaw! The old school of downhilling was legendary men of great courage and luck with little appreciable technique. Today's downhill racer must be a master of aerodynamics, edge control, and body movement so refined that only those who couple technique along with courage will be competitive. Downhill racing is still high risk and dangerous, but a closer look shows a more exacting sport. One of the most important facets of successful downhilling is the element of air drag and the aerodynamics of the skier. From the earliest days of skiing till now, downhill racers have been aware of their aerodynamic form. Today, skiers are tested early in the season in a wind tunnel, where they find their most efficient and comfortable tuck position. These aerodynamic tucks will be fought for at 70 miles per hour down the side of the mountain, where those who hold good form save fractions of precious seconds. Custom bent perfectly around a streamlined body suit. To reduce any wind drag, plastic balls or cones replace baskets as equipment refinements can be thousands of a second. These poles and arms of a downhiller are an important part of control. The weight of the ski pole provides counterbalance, essential to sport where stability is so fragile. The hands may move laterally, but always remain in front of them. Possible recovery from dangerous situations are good, only if the downhiller has his hands driving forward.
Yo.
The pros.
The amateur, the pro. Nice shades, man. They're mine.
Yeehaw!
What's up, then? Who jumped on that?
We're bad.
What?
Jump on me.
In its most traditional form, downhill races were exactly that, straight downhill. Today's skiers, however, are masters of the high-speed turn. Courage is still rewarded, but the emphasis of today's elite is on the skiing skill. Namely, the ability to put the ski on edge and carry momentum through the turn and down the side of a mountain. It is here, in the turn, where the gold will be won. Or it is edge control that enables the great ones to execute the perfect turn. Those turns where the tail of the outside ski falls in the same groove created by the tip. In the vernacular of the sport, this is the carved turn. A successfully carved turn means no speed is lost and momentum is maintained.
How do you account for that one, Jason?
It's sad. This is for a jump. When you're coming off a jump, you have to have a downhill. I you can't have a straight.
Our news commentator gave it a 2.
Oh, you guys didn't take it. Mine was
I recovered. I just about bought it.
You didn't do it.
You can find it. Mine.
As early in the race, he's able to recover and go on and skate well.
Yeah, I didn't see where it was.
Yeah.
Maybe I'll find another good looking one. Play around in there. That's true.
Change them on you. You couldn't find a groove. How did you find it?
I don't know.
I can't twist around to get those guys. I'm gonna fall out.
Just leave the camera up here if you do. Alright.
Here we go. Going up to lunch.
Yeah.
It's a Kodachrome day today. Really nice.
Cool.
All right, we're coming up to the end now. Gonna go to lunch. There's the lodge. I can't see anything out of this. Are we almost there?
Yeah.
How far?
A little bit. Just about.
Pretty neat.
You know, when you have been on top before, you know what it feels like. You want to try to keep that feeling. You know, it is difficult to be on the losing end.
Okay, here we are on the head wall. It's about 4:00, I think. Okay, you gonna come? All right, I'm ready. Come on, chicken! Hurry up before I run out of battery! All right, he did it. Okay, Jason.
Come on, you wussy. Go straight down. Right. Yeah. Hurry up.
Go. Oh, you did it.
He's had an outstanding season.
Where's LeCount?
Come on, LeCount!
Kill yourself, LeCount!
Goodbye!
Come on, I want to see ya! A home run, man, let's do it!
Bomb it!
Come on, man! A 10! Let's
go!
Hurry up, the batter's run out! Do it!
Come on, my arms are getting tired!
Hurry up!
Where is he?
Dad, hurry up!
It's on, the battery's flipping.
Get him!
You're safe, look out! You're like Eddie the Eagle. Take your last run? Oh, you fell?
No,
that's a lot of land.
So how was school?
Go well. Couldn't be better in the city.
My work is just like a hobby.
I'm tired.
But, you know, pass the time. Get it done.
Out of the downhill.